Hi, I am Aina Jadalala binti Omar. My trips number 200420.
Hi, my name is Rajkin binti Mama Hanafi and my matrix number is 200531.
Hi, my name is Nur Ibad Zmandi binti Isman and my matrix number is 200613.
Hi, my name is Nur Emilia Afarina binti Amal Fakarudin. My matrix number is 202674.
Hi, my name is Sadia binti Zukafi and my matrix number is 201073.
We are from Group 4 and we will be presenting to you guys about oxidation pond in sewage treatment plants in Malaysia and the world.
Oxidation pond can be defined as the lagoon or stabilization pond that stabilizes the domestic, trade and industrial waste by using the microbial interaction, primarily bacteria and algae. These organisms interact and modify the organic content of the waste to produce effluents which need further investment in treatment and researches. It is a natural process but require a large volume for its ecosystem. Oxidation pond also require the presence of sunlight and oxygen inside the confinement. It provides sustainable mechanism for dealing with sewage and for reducing the risk of infection from parasites and the effect of the toxins. It also helps to reduce and remove the pathogen and organic matter contained in wastewater. The sludges from the oxidation pond, we can use it as a fertilizer or be composted with the local vegetation. Then, when the direct disposal of the wastewater from factories and domestic residential area to the aquatic system, it can affect the life of water bodies and the water quality as well. So, oxidation pond is a method that we can be considered as a sustainable for wastewater treatment.
Tomorrow.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good evening to all of you. Thank you for coming to our webinar today. So the topic that we will be discussing today is about sewage treatment plants in Malaysia and the world. So the specified topic is about oxidation pond. But before we go to the presentation today, I would like to thank our presenter, which is Aina Juwadi Laila and also Izzah Ismahani. So now, we will go to the history of oxidation pond. So, do you know that oxidation pond has been developed since 3,000 years ago? And the first oxidation pond is in US, which is in San Antonio, Texas in 1901. Do you know that oxidation ponds have varieties of size, which is for the small size, it is used to treat wastewater generated by small communities in Europe. As for large oxidation ponds, which is we can see in New Zealand, Africa, and also Australia, it is used to treat wastewater from domestic to complex industrial effluent. It is used in wide range of climatic conditions, which is from tropical to Arctic. So in this slide, you can see that oxidation pond can be used alone or it can use in combination with other wastewater treatment processes. And do you know that oxidation pond required less energy and also low operation and maintenance costs. So that's all about the history of oxidation pond. So now I will let our next presenter, which is Aina Jordi Laila, to share with you about the oxidation pond, how it works.
Okay, thank you, Emilia, for the great explanation about the history of oxidation pond that you had just done just now. So I will be continuing about how does oxidation pond work. So basically, oxidation ponds are large yellow ponds that are designed to treat wastewater through interaction of sunlight, bacteria, and also algae. Algae grows by using energy from the sun and carbon dioxide and inorganic compounds that are released by bacteria in the water. And during photosynthesis, the algae will release oxygen needed by the aerobic bacteria. Sludge that are deposited in the pond must eventually be removed by dredging. And the algae that remains in the pond effluent can be removed by filtration or combination of chemical treatment and also setting. So we can all watch this video that I had prepared together to further enhance our understanding about how oxidation pond works and what is the mechanism of the oxidation pond. That is all for my part, and I will pass the next part to Isma to present about the advantages and disadvantages of oxidation ponds.
Okay, thank you, Ainajra. So I will continue to the advantages and disadvantages of oxidation ponds. So oxidation pond is actually reduce the biological oxygen demand up to 90% naturally. Also use algae and bacteria. So next, oxidation pond have a simple method to operate and does not require sophisticated equipment. It also does not require much labor power. Oxidation pond is an economical method for the treatment of wastewater from small and isolated units. So, of course, sometimes when we have advantages, we have disadvantages, right? So, disadvantages of oxidation pond is it require much land area. So, when we need more land area, we require a high capital cost depending on the price of the land. So, next, oxidation pond sludge require proper removal and treatment. If it's not treated properly, it will expose foul smell and it will turn to mosquito breeding center. And last but not least, oxidation pond may cause a groundwater pollution. So, I think that's all from us. Is there any question from the floor? Okay, if there is no question, so I would like to have one participant to conclude about our webinar for today.
May I conclude this webinar?
Yes, please.
So in my point of view, I would like to conclude that about the oxidation point is actually it can be considered as one of the suspected for the treatment of the wastewater in Malaysia. Although it has a few of the disadvantages that have been mentioned by one of our panels, such as the oxidation pond require a large amount of the area of land, but I believe the oxidation pond, it can work effectively in purifying the water and reuse the treated water in many ways. So I hope all of us that joining this webinar today can gain a lot of the knowledge. So have a nice day, everyone. Bye.
So So I guess that is all for our session today. And can everyone like pose for a picture for memories?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's all. Thank you, everyone. Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
So that is all from Group 4. Thank you and see you next time.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.